Returnable with SQL injection or not? And if so, we need to know what can we get from this vulnerability. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start using a vulnerability scanning tool, a tool that will scan the website for any vulnerability, SQL injection, cross-site scripting, any vulnerability. And according to the result, you're going to see what will be the next step. So there is many tools that allow you to do that in Kali Linux. So we're going to go to Kali. And we're going to go to web app. Let me just increase the size a little bit. So tools, first Kali Linux, here you go. And then let's see if we have anything related to web application, wireless web application, and web vulnerability scanning. And there is many tools, but myself, I prefer there is a tool by the name of Vega. It's a very, very powerful tool. You can try all of them. I mean, they will give you different results, but I'm going to start with Vega. Vega is a vulnerability scanning. I mean, it will not exploit. It will not hack. It will just show you the vulnerability inside the web application. And if there is a SQL injection, it will give you the infected link. And that what you need to use another tool, which is a SQL map tool, to start dumping the information from this database. So I open Vega application, which is a vulnerability scanning, and go to a new scan. So I'm going to scan and then choose new scan. And here I'm going to put the URL. So I don't think that I took the URL. So let's copy. Again, what I'm looking for, number one, if the web application is vulnerable or not. Number two, if it's vulnerable with SQL injection, I need the infected link. So I'm going to put here, and I'm going to click on next. And whatever remaining, I'm going to keep the same. I will not change any setting. Next, next, and finish. And then you're going to start scanning. This may take time. Depend on the size of the web application. It may take a few minutes. It may take 30, 35 minutes. It will take time according to the size. So what we're going to do, we're going to just pause until it finish, because it may take like 10, 15 minutes. And then we're going to see the result and see from where to take it. What should be the next step? So after completing the scanning, he's giving you a summary here. And we can see that he's infected with two SQL injections. There is two link infected with SQL injection. Okay. So SQL injection, we have two. Now, from where can we get this link? You double click here on the left side. And here is showing you the result. And those are the result of the scanning. The high one is 34. And we're going to check the SQL injection. Here you go. We have two link. And this is the first link. It's infected with SQL injection. Now, let's take this link and copy it and put it inside the browser, because this what will be working on it. This is what I'm looking for, the infected link. So I'll open here a browser. It's already open. And I will open a new tab. And this is the infected SQL injection link. This what do you need to be able to get the remaining of information. So once I get this link, I have two. I mean, if this one is not working, you can try the second one. But definitely, if he's getting you the infected link, most of the time it's going to work. On the next lecture, we're going to see how to use this infected link to check what database they have on the server, what information they have inside. What are the user accounts and the user password? And the password is encrypted. He will also decrypt the password. So we're going to start using this amazing tool called SQL Map. Let's see how to use it.